Hey guys, welcome back. So in this video, we're gonna install these auxiliary wires and plugs into the Volkswagen Corrado, which is also the exact same as the Mark II Golf and the Mark III Golf and other platforms. So I think that's CE2. So in this video, let's do that. So the auxiliary plugs you're going to find on the CE2 loom. So anything that's brown is going to be negative, and they're all going to look the same and they're all going to join into the same place. Next, on the earlier cars, you'll have these floating plugs. So this one's red, but some of them are black and some of them are white. But by floating, I mean they'll be internally in the loom like this. They won't be into an actual block connector, or they won't fit into a certain place all joined together. These were then replaced by these type of connectors. They're a little bit more slicker, they're smaller, they're easier to hide and to move around inside the loom. So you'll either have these ones, or a combination of both. And then you have these block connectors. These block connectors, they're fairly rigid and they all fit into a single buzz bar. And that buzz bar sits on top of the CE2 box. So as you can tell, I am working on a Volkswagen Corrado. But a lot of this wiring that I am going to explain is also going to be the exact same, or near enough the exact same, to Volkswagen Golf Mark II, Mark III, Vento, Jetta, Polo, I think all the others. They're all CE2, so they're all going to be roughly the same. Depending on different years and different styles, so obviously the Corrado was a more advanced than the Mark II Golf and things like that, there's going to be some variation in the wire. Same with this one here, this is plug P. So on the early looms, there'll be an auxiliary on this one, and on the later cars, I think it was on plug K. So there's different things like that. There's small differences, but in the vast majority, it's all the same, and a lot of the time, all the wires will be the same color, so that you just join them. And the same with these guys here. Once you work out what they're for, if your car came with those auxiliaries, that's great. So like one might be for ABS. If your car didn't come with ABS, you're sorted. You don't need to worry about that wire. Other wires like these ones here, they might be for the heated windscreen, heated wing mirrors, heated washer nozzles for the front windscreen, things like that. If your car didn't have it, you don't need to worry about it. So these are all the auxiliary wires, but I'll go through that later on in the video. So guys, if you want to know what every single one of these pins do, you can do so by Googling CE2 diagrams. When you do, this will come up, which is A2 resource, and there it shows you all the diagrams of what every pin does, and it's a full breakdown. It's a great resource, definitely well worth checking out. Okay, and looking at our list, so we have the diagram here of what the back of the fuse board looks like. Okay, so I don't know how exactly to tackle this, so I think probably the best way to do it may be in sequence. So obviously the yellow ones over here are going to be A's, so that's A1 and A2, and there's indicators in these ones, so that's like for your dash to point, when you turn on the indicators, to point which way you're planning to indicate, left or right. On the early cars, they didn't have it, and both indicators just flashed together like as if you were pressing your hazards. Didn't really matter which direction you were going, left or right, but on the later cars, they actually told you, the dash would tell you left or right. So these two wires here, where are they gone? Here they are. That's them there. I've soldered onto them. So you have to tee into them and bring it down to here. This is the plug. And this plug here will go all the way up to your dash, and that is actually connected to these two blue plugs, which are in here, the light blue ones, which is U1 and U2. So we've done A1 and A2. Next is B, so you can see my B is missing, so that's only headlight washers, so we don't have that, so we can skip that one. Next one is C, nothing to report on C. Next one we have is D, so I'm going to explain what D is. Okay, so this is plug D, and this is the D loom, and you can see at the back there's loads of auxiliary. So D actually doesn't really connect into anything directly into the car. It's only there for if you want to run a load of auxiliaries that either are live all the time, live with the key, or live with, say, like when you turn on the fog lights or your demister. So what D is usually responsive for is, I'll show it on the screen now. So at the end of the D loom, you have all these little auxiliaries, and I absolutely hate these because they don't really plug directly into anything that you can spot very easily. So where do they actually go? Well, if you look at the very back of your, or the top of your fuse box, you can see they all plug in. So kind of the rule of thumb is the same color plugs get plugged in together. Okay, so counting down, so you, at the top, we go left, right, so it's 1, 2, 3. So this big heavy yellow and black wire, looks white, but it's yellow and black, with a yellow plug at the end. We're going to find it inside here and see where it goes. So D is way off up here, and this is the yellow plug just here, and we're going to also plug in, if you follow this wire here, this actually goes into our door for electric windows. So the yellow and black, this one just has a green plug on it just by chance, it actually goes into number 3 of D. So D3, which is going to be to power the electric windows. So we're going to plug that one in next. Okay, since we're in here, you might as well say, since we've worked out where this wire here goes, we're going to follow around this wire, which is a green and white wire. A bit hard to see, a bit overexposed. Goes from this black plug into this white plug, and it's joined down here at black K12. So there's it is. That's the wire there. So looking at it there now, so that's D1, D2, D3, which we've just used, D4, D5, D6 are all empties, and then the next one is D7. So this one here, D7, is on my car, it's auxiliary because it's for ABS. So the next one we're going to look at is D8, which is the big black wire. So the black wire, so difficult to see it, but it's in there and it's actually linked to E2. So these two wires just in here are linked together, so D8 is linked to E2. Okay, next we're going to locate loom 3, which is this one here. You can see there's a 3 written on it. And there's two wires, so there's a big fat red wire. Follow the big fat red wire around, and we're going to go and we plug it in there down here into Y. So Y1 or Y2 is where I have it, Y1. And then there is a blue and black wire. Here it is. This blue and black wire. Follow it around. That's one plug. There is a heated windscreen. That's this wire here, which I have laid out. Yep. That's this one here that comes, you'll see it just up there. So these two wires will now connect to D9. There's one little wire in there. There's one in, and now get the other two wires in. D10, which is automatic seatbelts, we don't need them. D11 can also be linked to E2. D12, which is this one here, and it's the light grey one. So it's connected into this wire here, which is light blue, which is this loom here, which goes over to the radio and the dash. So if you have auxiliary gauges in the center pod, that's where they would get their lighting power from, and it also lights up the ring around the cigarette lighter and the radio and heater controls and everything like that. So that's where that light there is controlled from, and obviously then when you dim it here, it'll also dim the power here, which will dim all the lights over here. On some models, but not this car, on E3 there's a spare wire, which is this one here, and it is connected to H7. Ignore J3, it is for the headlight dimming, so it's like for daytime running lights, but no one uses it. So J3, ignore that. Next is K12, so we've done that one already. So K12 is the demist for the back window, and we've plugged in our demist into our wing mirrors. So when we turn on our demist, we'll both heat the back window and our wing mirrors. So power for the OBD1, OBD2, internal lights and center locking is this wire here. It has a black connector, a big square black connector, and that goes to L7. Next we're looking at Q2, which is a blue wire. It's the second wire down. It's this big heavy yellow wire. It joins into this black plug, which goes over to the HVAC fan. Next, if you have a corrado, you look at W1, which is the green one just up here. This is this blue wire comes down here. It tees off, or sometimes you can have these little auxiliary plugs. And mine goes, where is it? Here. It goes into this white plug, and from here it goes onto the spoiler. So if you're driving and your spoiler isn't going up and down, this wire here isn't connected. The back of W1 is actually connected to G111. That's how it knows when you're going fast or slow enough to put up and down the spoiler. Next we look at U1, U2, which is the blue wires or blue plugs down here. And this is the loom for the cluster. These two wires here, going nice and close, they're for the indicators, which were A1 something and A2 something. You'll figure it out. These two here are totally auxiliary, you don't plug them in. One is, I think it was airbag or to tell you to put on your seatbelt, and the other one was to say that the boot is open or the brake pads are worn down. The corrado doesn't have either of those features, so they are auxiliary. You don't use them. I always put a knot onto all the wires that I'm not going to use. That way, even if I'm looking back, if I find a wire and has a knot on it, it means don't use it. It's not needed. Also on the cluster is this purple and white wire. So that goes to the cluster. You can see the plug way off in there is black plug, and there's a yellow one, but it should be normally purple or black. And the other half of that wire is purple, and it goes to ECU. So that
tells the cluster how many miles per gallon or liter per 100 kilometers you're doing.
Also coming from the engine bay loom, you can see there in the top corner, there's a wire, and if we follow it around, it actually ends up over here. And there's a set of plugs just in there. This is the wire of our trip we're following around, and that's actually the K or the L line for the diagnostics. Sometimes the diagnostics will have this plug, so you can see this one, I have the grey wire in, but I have grey and yellow out, so if the yellow isn't being used. All the diagnostic wires all end up in the same place. So this is a little buzz bar, a little junction box, so all the grey lines are all connected down this way, and all the yellow ones are all connected down the far side. So what do they all do? Well, this one here is probably coming from the engine. That's what you have the grey wire for. This one here is probably coming from the ABS. And this one here is coming out and going to the OBD2 plug. The nice thing about this system is if you had another thing, say like airbags or different other modules that you wanted to plug in, you can plug them all in here and straight away they're all connected to the OBD2 outlet. Next, just for the VR6, or maybe for other cars, I'm not really sure, but definitely for the VR6, we have these two wires which have knotted together. They come straight from the engine loom. So we're going to have a look where they go. So one is blue and white, which has a blue plug, and that goes to W1. The other half of the blue and white wire goes into the ECU, and that tells the ECU how fast the car is going. The other wire is yellow and black. It has a yellow plug, goes to the D connectors. It doesn't really matter which wire it goes to, as long as it's 12 volt with key on and 0 volt with key off. This is the yellow and black wire. You can see it's going to an auxiliary temperature gauge on the manifold for the water temperature. Next we have to connect all the negatives, and you can see all the negatives have a quick release block here at the top. A bit hard to see, but it's up here. That's located on the A pillar at the very top behind the light switches, so it's probably up about here. It is very difficult to see, but pin 30 and 30B must be joined together. So this is a breakout joiner, but sometimes it does have a big jumper wire, which is just a wire joining from this pin back to this pin. So they need to be connected or else your car won't start. These pins are separated because there's an immobilizer. So guys, thanks very much for watching. If you've been watching the video and this video has helped you, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe over there or over there, I can't never remember which side it's at. And also, if it's really helpful, you can give me a donation. There's a button just down here. It says it's a heart with super thanks in it. And any donation will absolutely help me. It'll help me buy more car parts or whatever else. But this video is designed not to be so much entertainment as to more help people, because I've done projects like these before on Mark II Golf and Mark III Golf and of course on the Corrados, and these wires always get me. I have never been able to find a definitive guide of how to go through it and explain what every single wire does. Now, I haven't explained every single wire, but I've explained the vast majority of wires. I'm sure there's going to be wires I've left out. If there is, leave a comment down below, which will help other people. Explain the type of plug it's on, the location. This type of plug, is it a big block plug? Is it one of these cute little tiny plugs? Or is it one of these plugs here? I don't have ABS, that's why I didn't go through the ABS one. But explain where it goes, explain where the two wires are, that kind of stuff. That will definitely help other people. I've tried to do my absolute best and give a definitive guide of where everything goes. I'm sure there's going to be comments down below. I've missed stuff, I've left stuff out, but so be it. Anyway, thanks very much for watching. If this video has helped, do give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and as always, guys, thanks for watching. See you later.